The front rooms. Survival of class hero. Safe, secure, devoid of entities. The front rooms is our home. It could be considered as a polar opposite to the back rooms. The front rooms is a term from anywhere outside the bounds of normal reality. It's outside the back rooms. A statement often brought to question by the existence of the blue channel. The front rooms exist in the space of one universe, with this universe holding a number of galaxies. A singular galaxy can have billions of stars. Most of these stars have a cluster of orbiting planets. Home. Well, I'm sure I could write on about the stars and gas giants and planets made of diamonds. That's not what you're here for, is it? It's certainly not up here. You heard a reminiscence. You want to remember Earth. I remember walking down the street on a blistering cold morning, knowing that you can miss the bus because your parents are distracting you from leaving. Remember those feelings? I'm not gonna be better now. I'm sure your body clock has stopped the clock in these days, weeks, and years have passed by. How are your friends? Are they missing you? You let your life go on without them. You're here. You're alive. Yes, they currently are. I'm sure you may think that your friends are lost and grieving. That may make you sad, angry, confused about why it had to be the fault of the fort. But if you can move on so easily, that's why they called away, they can too. This page to keep your spirits up. The back rooms is tough. It tests you, not only physically, but mentally too. Please, don't give up like I have. There isn't anything left for me, but by choices have damned me to my current life. You, however, still have a chance. Please don't let the back rooms ride you away. Be better than sure you're not afraid of what I can do. Bases, communities, and outposts. Earth. The front room says over 7.5 billion people on Earth. We're beings of war. We've always been in conflict with one another. I suppose a good thing of not being in the front rooms now. There are no looming threats of war overhead. And then maybe that's something you miss. Entrance and exit. If there's an entrance here, I'm sure we'd all use it now. There's a few, actually. Little 399, the end. I mean, you can run some stupid thing in it. Or like, you know, so I go through the way out. So yeah. There's a wicked out and there's no entrances. Exits, falling to the floor, or has been coined by many groups as no climbing. It's a very reliable way of getting here. Maybe you could share how we got here? No, I was on my way to work. I was late and running down the road. And I was sick and heavy. I remember the noise, extremely heavy rain made of my umbrella. How the rain would hit my hood when my arm swung under the umbrella. Then I slipped. There was no rain in the road, just yellow and lots of it. Please make choices of the better ones I did. Level 0. If you're not careful, no clip out of reality in the wrong areas will end up in the back rooms where it's nothing but the stink of old mud carpet, minus a mono yellow, the endless background noise of fluorescent reds, max humbus, and approximately 600 million square miles of randomly segmented empty rooms to be trapped in. God save you, hear something wandering around nearby, because it sure as hell has heard you. Seems like they changed level 0 from class 1 to class 0. Safe, secure, devoid of entities. Level 0 is the first level of the backrooms and the first level main encounter. Level 0 is a nonlinear space, resembling the backrooms or retail outlet, thus the name the backrooms. Similar to its previous form, which is over here, it's the class 1. The installed light flickers constantly and hums at a constant frequency. This buzzing is notably louder and more destructive. God, the ordinary fluorescent humming. The examination of the fixtures to determine the source has been inconclusive. Since when saturating the carbon cannot be consistently identified. It is not water. It's not safe to consume, obviously. Why would we do that anyway? So basically, level 0, the retail outlet in the back rooms of a retail it. Yeah, with all yellow walls, stinky moist carpets, and hum buzzing lights, and all just yellow, as you can see. Tan carpet. All just yellow. And your space from level 0 is altered drastically. It's possible if you walk in a straight line, it's returned back to your starting point, and you're going back and going to the place you went to, and then going back to your starting point can lead to a whole different location. So yeah, you're going up and down. So if you go right, you could just going down and down, click to left and up to down and la la la. So yeah. And since that exists, the GPS and compasses fail within the level because it's so disorienting and stupid and blah, blah, blah. So yeah, level 0 is entirely still, devoid of life, despite the fact that its primary interest is back rooms. The contact with the wanderers and within this level has not been reported. So basically, the level just gives you invisibility until you leave the level. So yeah, that's great. A great number of people have died before exiting. The cause is probably dehydration, starvation, physical trauma due to the sensory deprivation and isolation. Because I would go insane too. But anyway, I noticed about the back room, so I clip back to the level 1 or take me to the front room. So whatever. No corpses have been reported from these pathological deaths. And then to enter level 0 and a group will result in the separation of the group until you exit the level to level 1. Hallucinations are common levels here. Most common being hunting for lighting, increasing and deafening volume. Yeah. Just read this. Going to the analysis, the CO2 and levels within level 0 are rising at a steady rate. The significance of this is unknown. So yeah, you're gonna have to breathe CO. You're gonna have to bring carbon. Breathe carbon dioxide whenever, like after a few years of level 0 existing. Now on. So yeah, bring an oxygen tank whenever you enter the back rooms. Yay. Entrances and exits. Accidentally, no clipping to the bounds of just no clipping through the reality of existence and everything, and blah, blah, blah. And like just fall off of everything. And then the way of exiting level 0. Or you can just, enter the other levels too. Like, item level, I don't know. I think that's the only way you can enter level 0. There's a few entrances to level 0 and other levels in the back rooms, well, whatever. I don't know what they are. The fortresses of level 283 are rarely contain wooden doors that smell mold. Entering doors lead to level 0. Okay, I'm sorry to say that. No entities are within the level, including other humans. If you hear Caldera, it's not a human. So yeah. Exiting level 0 is only possible by no-clipping. It's the only documented way to exit the level. The safe way. As newcomers to level 0 are often unfamiliar with the mechanics of the background, it's necessary to keep your bearings and adapt quick to the environment in order to exit. The entrance to the Manila room is where possible walking a grid in the other direction. Unlike level 0, wanderers can meet freely in the Manila room. But the room is a dead end, rather, it functions as a rendezvous room for wanderers to survive the trek. Actually, documentation from the Meg can be found in the Manila room. Major export group. Assisting newcomers and surround escape. Instructions count on no clip. Can be found in the documents. Because this is data missing. I don't know what the heck. The Manila room. Safe, secure, avoidant entities. The Manila room is a small room that can very rarely be found on level 0. Often it's a safe point where wanderers meet and travel through the level. The Manila room is isolated, square room with thick walls within level 0. It has minimal furnishings which vary between slightly different appearances. Usually no more than table and chair and 1-4 entrances. Yeah, it's great. The Manila room is commonly used as a meeting point for wanderers. I already said that. Wait, hold on. Oh, okay. So you just fade back into existence and into the manila room. Because we are taken to avoid entering this from the same entrance at the same time. So if you enter at the same time, something bad is gonna happen. Probably gonna go to level question mark exclamation. So yeah. Level 9233372386347410 or 807. Yeah. Anyways. The person said, I don't want to explain that, whatever. Level 0. Back to level 0. Back over here. Exits. Level 1. Title difficulty, safe, secure, devoid of entities. Level 1 is a large sprawling warehouse that features concrete floors and walls, exposed rebar, and a low-hanging fog with no discernible source. The fog often coalesces to condensation, which forms puddles on the floor in areas. So yeah, low-hanging fog. Unlike level 0, this level possesses a constant supply of water and electricity and other stuff, which allows them to... which allows habitability by wanderers. Goddamn my English. Why does my English suck though? Providing that appropriate precaution taken is also far more expensive, possessing staircases, elevators, and isolated rooms. Now, entity 81. Hold on, it's elevators or entities? Hold up. Okay. Crates of supplies appear and disappear randomly within the level, often containing a mixture of vital items, food, and water, batteries, tarps, weaponry, clothing, medical supplies, and nonsensical stuff that just don't do anything, like cardboard boxes, crayons, syringes, partially burned paper, live mice, and a carton that took a tin mixtape and been injected with some unknown substances, choices, loose change, bundles of human hair. The grace should be a perfect precaution due to the contents, whatever about you, so yeah. Don't approach the crates for them, but approach the crates, so yeah. Pick a poison. Don't use the crates or go to the crates. In addition, crude paintings and drawings with no apparent origin or meaning appear on the walls and floors. They are known to change in appearance once you, like, look away for, like, a centisecond. They change or disappear. So, yeah. Hallway of level 1. The lights within level 1 are prone to flicker and fail sometimes. When this occurs, supplies just vanish instantly, and many hostile entities appear unexpectedly. These entities rarely attack in groups and tend to avoid light in large gatherings of people. So, if you're with, like, 10 people, let's say, they're not going to want to attack, because they're gonna probably are gonna think they're going to die. So, yeah. It's advised to carry a reliable light source and sleep, holding whatever items you do not wish to lose. So, basically they're saying that, if you, it's also been seen that if you, like, hold onto the item, it won't disappear if the lights go out. So, if you just leave it there, it'll disappear. I just disappear random times, so yeah. Make sure you, you get there. If you walk far enough in level 1, you will go to the hub, which is a yellow, which is a place that is a safe, secure, devoid of entities. It's a, cool place. It's a just a yellow hallway that goes on for all infinity. And that's what I think called Tom's Diner. A lot of bases and good stuff. Yeah, basically a chill place. Back to level 1. This is the first main base of the med, so yeah, they went to level 1. About half of the group's team members live here, mainly housing explorers and supply outposts shared with the BNDG, back in the whole script group. The base is cluster 1, entrance of level 1, heavily guarded against threats such as entity attack. Backrooms National Trade Group, Traders Keep. Traders Keep is a large city-like complex, around 412 inhabitants, non-hostile, possesses societal infrastructure, main supply hub for water. Traders Wall set up in store tall level 1. Keeps communications and my relations with Meg. So yeah, Meg and the BTG are friends. This is storage hall. Oh, here it is. Yeah, we don't need that. Let's talk about the main place. I said wiki dot turned J, so that's just great. Cause why? Oh, you can exit entrance level 1 by level 0 from just glitching existence. This level has many entrances, opening ordinary doors, and many levels of the chance of leaving to level 1. So just open a door that says level 1, you'll be taking a level 1. So, okay. Epic. Additionally, climbing to one of the trees in level 11.1 will take you here. The end of the fifth event in level 92 will put you there. Completing the King's Trial level 94 will take you here. All rubble is returning to level 1. So I want to see this. Like a second. Okay, once I enter this level 11.1, I'm definitely going to want to climb a tree instantly. finding holes in the walls. So here are the exits. You just leave level 1 by continuing to explore the level. Wandering down any extended hallway leads to level 2. Hiding holes in the wall that would lead to level 19. Where the ceiling has paintings on it. Where, you know, so if there's a ceiling that's painted on it, no crypto and you'll be at a party. Yay! Finding out more colors in various locations, level 1. No apparent source has been found. The artist lives with me. The artist dies with me. Then must stay after party. Burn my freaking body. The blue word beckons you. The student. You choose you. Who's safe here? Black queen to H5. And that's chicken. Watch the clock. The final prophecy there is there. Some truths are best left as lies. Level 2. Class 2. Safe. Unsafe. Secure. Devoid of endings. I'd rather put it unsafe, unsecure, because there's no security in there. No entity count. Epic. Let's use a third level of backrooms. And it's the last of the ones you could start out in. So you can just no clip here from actual reality and end up here. So most people are on the level 0, some on level 1. But if you're really unlucky, you're on level 2. And if you do, you're really unlucky. You're like one of the luckiest persons alive. So just pray. If backrooms actually does exist, then just hope you don't land on level 2 of any level. Level 2 consists mainly dark gray concrete maintenance tunnels, stretching on for millions of miles. The walls are lined with pipes and occasional ventilation ducts. Droppings contain thick, vicious, black liquid. Doors can sometimes be found, but most are locked or lead to dead ends. Pigeons typically have shells with random assortments of objects, occasionally computers. At certain parts of the hallways in level 2, the heat can become unbearable, reaching 43 degrees Celsius. Doesn't sound too bad, but 110 degrees Fahrenheit, no thank you, or higher, which is deadly. This usually is areas where the machinery is the loudest, typically at the end of the hallways. So if you hear loud machinery, I don't think I want to stick around, so yeah. The entities in the final level are most dangerous in the back rooms. Noise can be heard from the vents, which are caused by crawlers. You can also find the mark employee in bathrooms on level 2. For others, include smilers, face, child facelings, clumps, hounds, meddlers, mobs, which are friendly, wretches, plague goblins, bursters, and skin stealers. I never seen plague goblins or bursters. So yeah, they probably added new. They probably rebranded a lot of levels ever since like the new update happened like in mid-May. There's bases, outposts, and communities. Survivors. A group of about 29 people who explored the level. Just explored it, so nothing much. Leader is named Austin, and they're friendly and open to trade. They hold their supplies and wooden crates from level 1. So just take it from level 1 and go to level 2. They're first to discover what riches were, so, yeah. This group is often in a complex with followers of Jerry Outpost. Followers of Jerry are led by these this Jerry Bird thing. Yeah. You shouldn't touch him. Then just don't touch the bird. Office Space EL3A. Office Space in level 2, home to around 30 members of the BNTG. To see more info, see Office Space EL3A. No, thank you. Entrance and exit. Entrances. Level 2 is one of the only levels in the back of the academy access to normal reality. You can come across level 2 by exploring long enough in level 1. Only access from the hub, so you just enter a door. The front rooms? Exits. Contrary to popular belief, is not all the doors on level 2 are locked or lead to dead ends. Some can lead to level 3 or even 4 or back to level 1. I'd rather go to level 1 or 4. Finding a comically proportioned multicolored door that's unlocked leads to 283, which is a bounty castle or assemble some kind of Burger King or McDonald's place. If you know go to an extremely hot area in level 2, you can wind up in level 2.1, which is, I do not recommend doing that. I hope you enjoyed watching the video of, mashed up video of level, the first three levels, and the enigmatic level known as the front room. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in our next video! Goodbye. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.